James D. Buzzard, and I have absolutely no idea how to start this video or introduce this new topic to the channel. So I guess I'm just gonna start with a super short story of how I got intrigued by this subject in the first place. So about, 12, 13 years ago now, back in 2010, I got my very first trip to a dark room, a photography dark room where film is developed. And this was actually just at my local college, Aurora University. One of my friends was going to school there for marketing, and she was taking a general photography class where they were using 35 millimeter film cameras to, you know, learn about photography and producing images and all of that kind of stuff. And at the time, I had absolutely no experience with film photography other than, you know, my mom back when I was a kid, probably 2005-ish or something, you know, shooting 35 millimeter film when we were kids with the point and shoots. And my dad had a pretty cool Minolta. Zero experience with 35 millimeter film. I got invited over to the dark room. I'll leave that at that. But we ended up developing film. She showed me the entire process of how to develop film. It was super fun. And it really, really got me intrigued into these old cameras. They literally are like fine watches. Is the way they work, and they and I was just super intrigued by that whole developing process, working with the developer and the fixer and the you know, things that you would use to actually project the negatives onto the paper and putting it in the water stuff. I haven't developed since then, but it was a super fun process and I really enjoyed it. And since then, I definitely wish she would have taken me back there a couple more times, but she only really had to do it like once or twice for the class, and then the class was over. So anyways, that was the end of my darkroom experience right there. But I've always been super, super intrigued by 35 millimeters ever since. And getting into cameras more in 2012, I always have kept going back and looking into 35 millimeter cameras. I've always enjoyed watching 35 millimeter and 120 medium format videos here on YouTube. And over the past like four or so years, I've really been watching a ton of videos on, you know, just film in general, specifically King Japes, Analog Resurgence. Even recently, I've been watching a ton of One Month Two Cameras and Lucy Lumens. I've been watching tons of people all across the board. Those just shout out to a few, but they've really kind of influenced me to make this new purchase that I'm about to show you guys. But I finally jumped on getting a 35 millimeter film camera. And I did a ton of different research with some of the channels that I mentioned, along with many others. And I, you know, searched, scoured the internet. I went all over the Canon history page, which is a great, great research source if you guys are looking into old film cameras. If you guys just want to see like generations of Canon's film cameras, which is super interesting, kind of a hint at what I got. But, there's tons of resources out there that you can really do a ton of research and find a good camera for a good price. But I ended up landing on this camera right here. This is the Canon AF35M. This is Canon's very first 35 millimeter automatic point and shoot film camera. So this camera is from 1979, which just so happens to be the exact same year as the motorcycle I'm currently building. So I thought that was super, super cool. You know, just kind of goes with the old classic little bike I'm building right now, which maybe I'll introduce you guys or just quick, super quick video if I can do one of those. I don't know. But this camera is an awesome little camera. I did a ton of research and this camera seems to be built pretty much like a tank. And we're gonna test it out here in just a few minutes. But just a few reasons why I ended up landing on this camera. One, you can actually have manual control over the ASA or the film speed that you guys have inside of your camera. So if you guys are shooting 400 speed and you want the image to be a little bit brighter, you can actually shoot this thing at 200 speed and that will force the camera to expose the image longer and create a brighter image, which is a little cheat that a lot of people do shooting film, depending on what film stock they're using. Additionally, this thing has a pop-up flash, which I don't know if the flash works quite yet, but again, we're gonna test it out here in just a minute. I'm super, super excited to test this thing out. And it has a built-in little self-timer. I'm not sure if the little self-timer works. I did look up how to use this camera, and you can just kind of cancel it by flicking it back up before you hit the shutter. I don't know if I just might have messed something up right there. Don't hit the shutter if you have that thing down. But another thing that this thing has is automatic rewind. So you're able to hit this little button here in the bottom, and that allows the spool in here to go backwards. And then you're supposed to be able to just rewind it using this little rewind thing right there, and it's supposed to automatically rewind the film, and then you can pop your film out and put in a new roll and get the previous one developed, I guess. That's the idea. I haven't done it yet. So anyways, so I really want to test this camera out. So first things first, guys, let's pop some batteries in this thing and see if it's actually working. Let's go ahead and pop this battery door open. I know it's apparently these battery doors can be delicate, so I just want to be gentle with it. It's an old, old, old camera from 1979. So let's check this guy out. We're gonna pop in one battery. If you guys notice, the biggest reason I got this camera was this battery door right here has no corrosion in it, which I believe means it was most likely stored without the batteries in it for a long period of time, or maybe it was just used over a long period of time and somebody kept good care of it, took good care of it. So that's the biggest reason I paid the price that I paid for this thing. And we'll get into that, where I bought this camera and all that, just in a minute. But now that we got the batteries in, there is pressure on the switch. We had a sound. Let's pop up the flash and let's just test the whole thing. Ready, guys? 3, 2, 1, smile. Yes. All right, so we got a flash, we got some noise, we had some shutter sounds. Let's actually see if the shutter is working on this thing. And 3, 2, 1. Oh, let's close this guy real quick. And yeah, our shutter is opening and closing. If you guys can see this through there, let's see. And yes, you guys can see that shutter opening and closing. So I don't know if the timing is correct. I don't know if the exposure meter is working correctly. We don't know any of this kind of stuff. But in order to give this camera its best chance on its first roll of film, and I don't know how long it's been since this camera has been shot. I got it. We'll get into that in just a minute, where I got it from. But I say let's go ahead and clean this camera all up. Now, I'm not gonna bore you guys with cleaning this camera. Instead, I'm gonna use me cleaning this camera as some B-roll, and I'm gonna talk to you guys about where I ended up looking for different cameras to buy. And I wanna talk to you guys about, you know, the three kind of places I would go to look for 35 millimeter film cameras, and then we'll talk about the price and all that kind of stuff. So I've actually found that the best places, or the best available places for me, as far as finding some of these old 35 millimeter cameras, is number one, which I did not personally do, is you guys could give a quick little shout out on Facebook. You guys could reach out to some family members and stuff like that and see if they have old 35 millimeter stuff laying around, stuff that they wouldn't mind if you took off their hands to, you know, play around with and use. So that's definitely a route that you guys could go. Now, if you guys are just looking to buy something, I think the three best places, especially for me and my area, which I live just outside Chicago: Facebook, Marketplace, eBay, and your local thrift shops and retail stores. I found on Facebook Marketplace, everybody who's selling on Facebook Marketplace, for the most place, is on Facebook pretty frequently. So you get replies back super quick when you guys are looking to actually purchase something or ask somebody about their 35 millimeter camera. So I just found Facebook to be an awesome place to go to just kind of do a general 35 millimeter film camera search, see what's in your area, and it will save you a ton of time from going out to thrift stores and just kind of checking to see what they have on the shelves. Moving on, the next one is obviously eBay. I think eBay is an awesome option, and you can find some cameras at really, really good prices, but a lot of the cameras at good prices tend to be listed as untested. And I hate throwing money at cameras that are potentially untested, broken even. You just really don't know the actual condition outside of the photos of the camera. And when you ask some of these guys if they're willing to test it, they'll just say, no, it's being sold as is, and stuff like that. So that is kind of shitty. But on Facebook, people are a lot friendlier. They'll take the time to throw some batteries in it, especially if they're not getting hit up with a billion replies for the camera. Moving on, your thrift shop. It seems to be an awesome spot to find cameras. I've been watching a ton of thrift shopping videos on, you know, camera thrift shopping, especially on King Jape's channel. And it does seem like there are a ton of film cameras out there to be found. I just haven't made the time to actually go out and do that. So you definitely can find these cameras cheap. Whether or not they work will be in a future video potentially, but got this camera on Facebook Marketplace. The seller was super, super friendly. He let me know everything about the camera. The camera, it was a little bit dirty because it's been in an old camera bag, but at the same time, he did test it out just with some batteries, and he said it seemed to be fully functional and working. Now, it's not film tested, so we are gonna need to test it with some film, which is what we're about to do at the end of this video. But as far as I know, this camera should be fully operational. So let's cross our fingers. That is where I have been looking for my 35 millimeter film cameras. And now that we're actually done cleaning this camera up, let's test it out, put some film in it, and see if it works. And there we go, guys. So we just got this Canon AF35M all cleaned up and ready to go. And as you guys can see, you guys might be able to tell why I paid just a little bit more for this camera than I probably should have. This thing was, you know, $80 to $100, and you can typically pick them up for anywhere between $40 to $60 in pretty good condition, and even less than that if you guys are willing to pick up an untested model. But that could be super iffy, picking up an untested model. I'd rather just pay for something that I know that is supposed to work. But we got this awesome little strap for it right here. We kind of borrowed that off of a donor camera. If you guys want to see the whole cleaning process and how I got this strap, make sure that you guys check out the cleaning video that I'm going to post separately. But this thing is officially ready to put some film in it. So let's go ahead and put some film in it finally. And but I guess before we even put the film in it, this is gonna take kind of a hard decision. Now, I have three different kinds of film stock currently available to me. This one right here is Kodak Gold at a 200 speed or ISO 200. I don't know if I want to use this one. This one, I think, is expired because it's from 2014. I'm not sure how long film lasts, but again, this roll right here is from 2014. This roll right here is Kodak Portra 400. Now, this is like Kodak's best film that they have, and I paid $20 a roll at my local camera store for it. So for, you know, a 5-pack, you're paying $100, which is very, very steep for film. This stuff right here is Fujifilm 200 speed, and I got this just at my local Meijer for $20 plus some tax, you know. But this is 200 speed, so I'm not sure which one I really want to use. To be honest, I really want to use the Portra 400 and just give it a go. and see what it's like over the next couple days, but I don't know which one I should go with. Let me know in the comment section down below which film stock you guys would have went with out of these three. If you guys would have went with the Portra 400, the Fuji at 200 speed. This is just Fuji Superior, I believe. It actually does not say Superior on it, but I believe this is just Fuji Superior. And this one right here is, again, Kodak Gold, but I believe it is expired. So that could be interesting, but this is my first roll of film that I'm going to be getting developed. I really kind of want to just go with the Portra 400. You know what? I'm going to put one of these films in. If you guys know what it is, leave it in the comment section down below. But I'm gonna load this thing up. I'm just gonna bust out one of the films right now. While I'm busting out this film, maybe you guys could leave that comment down below which one you guys would have went with. So I was gonna have you guys guessing as to which film stock I actually ended up going with, but I've decided to go with the Fuji Color Fujifilm. I believe this is just Fuji Superior. Nothing fancy or anything like that. I'm probably going to shoot it at an ISO lower than what it actually, than the actual film speed, meaning I'm going to shoot it at 100, even though it's 200, because I heard that's just the best way to get the best results out of this film stock. But again, I'm not 100% sure because this is my first time shooting film, and I'm super excited to get this thing over and onto here. I don't really want to damage it at all. Let's see if I can actually get it on film like intended. All right, so loading up our film, all we're gonna do is kind of just get it dropped into there like so. It pretty much just falls into place, to be honest. We're gonna pull a little bit extra out, just enough to get our leader going into here. So we need to pull just a tiny bit more to get that leader out. I was trying to save as much film as possible, but yeah, I wanted to be a little difficult. So now that we got, oh no, I'm messing up apparently. So let's get that over to there. Let's hit this, and it should pull it over a little bit. Nice, nice. Close that up, hit it once, and then I guess you hit it twice, and now you're ready for your first shot. So this right here is my very first shot of 35 millimeter film. I'm super, super, super excited to try this thing out, and you know what? I'm definitely gonna pop the flash up for it. You know I gotta pop the flash up for it. So we're gonna do a number one right here like this. This might be the thumbnail, you never know. Three. Oh, we're shooting it at ISO 400. Guys, we gotta adjust that. All right. Do a number one for the first shot. Let's see if we got it. I don't know if that shot's gonna turn out. We'll do a number two for the second shot. Two is for a peace out as well. Nice, I love it. All right, this is gonna be friggin' fun, guys. I am so excited to try this thing out. That is pretty much all I had for today's video, guys. It looks like this camera is functioning properly. It is rewinding. It seems to be taking pictures. We just took our first couple pictures on 35 millimeter film. I am super stoked to be taking this journey with you guys and for you guys to be kind of coming on this journey with me. So if you guys have any comments, questions, anything you guys want to add, leave it down in the comments down below. If you guys have been shooting film for a little while now, make sure you guys leave some pointers for all of us noobs to the game. Leave some pointers for us. Let us know like what film speeds we should be using. If you guys have a specific camera that you guys are in love with, let us know what it is. Yeah, just give us some information down below if you guys are more familiar with these 35 millimeter cameras than me, and specifically also my audience, because a lot of us are probably new to this. So I'm super excited to be shooting 35 millimeter film, super excited to show you guys my first developed roll of film, but that's pretty much all I have for today's video. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.